Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Yanyandira Purba from English Literature University of Sumatra Utara. We got an assignment again to make a forensic stylistic analysis from literary works. So, in this change, I'll try to fulfill the task titled of forensic stylistic analysis. The literary work that I'm gonna analyze is the English, Indonesian, and Mandarin song. So, check it out. First of all, this assignment entitled Forensic Stylistic Analysis on Literary Work, which contain the plagiarism. The objectives of the study are to find out the existence of plagiarism and to indicate the extent of plagiarism found in Indonesian songs in order to obtain the known order. Data of the study were collected from Mandarin, English, and Indonesian song from the release years between 2000 until 2018. The result of this study showed that the higher level of pitch was referred to the result of non-authorship of the song. Next, we continue about background of the study. Forensic linguistics is the scientific study of language as applied to forensic purpose and context. It is a very new area of linguistics vis-a-vis its 2400 year history and is a recent and rapidly growing area of modern applied linguistics. McManaman, 2002. Forensic linguistics also can be defined as taking linguistics knowledge, methods, and insights and applying this to the context of law, investigation, trial, punishment, and rehabilitation. Scientific method is forensic linguistics require hypothesis testing and integration independent testing of the method for its accuracy. Next, we continue about problem of the study. The problems of this research were formulated as follows. 1. What is linguistic is the existence of plagiarism in Indonesian song. 2. To what the existence of plagiarism was found in Mandarin, English, and Indonesian song. Next, we continue about objective of the study. In relation to the problems, the objectives of the study were identified as to indicate the existence of plagiarism found in English, Mandarin, and Indonesian song. Next, we continue about scope of the study. In accordance with the research problems, this study was focused on detecting plagiarism in the forensic stylistic analysis that taken from Indonesian and English song, namely Asal Kau Bahagia, Thinking Out Loud, and Seven Rings. Next, we continue about significance of the study. Theoretically, this research was expected to have both theoretical and practical contributions. The study covered an extensive body of research in the field of plagiarism in general, as well as plagiarism detection in particular across different disciplines, including linguistics, authorship, law, psychology, and sociology. Practically, forensic stylistics, as this work demonstrates, can make a special contribution to plagiarism detection. It has the potential to go further than the simple identification of the most evident instances of matching text, to investigate also obfuscated textual reuse and the possible intention of the plagiarist behind the reuse, to establish cases of plagiarism of ideas linguistically, and to demonstrate and explain why a certain instance, or even those apparently less evident, can be rather served. If we consider the legal implication of plagiarism in most countries, it is crucial that is a role for the forensic stylistics expert to frame a linguistics-based approach that takes into account the legal definition of plagiarism and the implications of this definition. Next, we continue about review of literature. 1. Forensic linguistics. Forensic linguistics, legal linguistics, or language and law, is the application of linguistic knowledge, methods, and insights to the forensic context of law, language, crime investigation, trial, and judicial procedure. It is a branch of applied linguistics. There are principally three areas of application for linguists working in forensic contexts. First, understanding language of the written law. Second, understanding language used in forensic and judicial processes. And third, the provision of linguistic evidence. Next, we continue about the important thing of this paper, that analyzes plagiarism on Indonesian and English song. 1. The song of Asal Kau Bahagia by Armada. Armada's music singles entitled Asal Kau Bahagia have been hits in the last 2 years. Unfortunately, the song was also accused of plagiarizing song from vocal group from Taiwan. F4. The tone of the song originally Asal Kau Bahagia, at a glance it is indeed similar in the refrain section of the song Liu Sing Ye, belonging to F4. Result vocalist of Armada implies that they have never been plagiarism in any world. A YouTube account with the name Afif Nur Aziza said in her comments if the song was similar to the boy band song F4. The F4 song in question is a song called Losing You, which is also the original soundtrack of the Asian drama Meteor Garden. The tone of the song is 90% similar to the tone of F4's Losing You song, which then can be heard in the chorus at the beginning of the sentence. Katakanlah sekarang bahwa kata bahagia aku punya ragamu, tapi tidak hatimu. Kau tak perlu berbohong, kau masih menginginkanmu. Kurelakan dengannya, asal kau bahagia. With Then she can lose you, the tide to teach you. Run me the little tie, you chain bar. Young Shan Sin, what the edge of a new young gun. Next, the song of Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran. Ed Sheeran is facing a legal case related to the plagiarism of his song, Thinking Out Loud. The song, which was released in 2014, is considered similar to the song Let's Get It On by Marvin Gaye, which was released in 1973. According to Louis, he found a significant similarity between the two songs. Among other things, melody, rhythm of harmony, low notes, and percussions. Although not all elements are related to copyright, Louis considers the similarity is sufficient to file a claim. And last, the song of Seven Rings by Ariana Grande. Seven Rings song, sung by Ariana Grande, received a ban which was considered as a case of plagiarism. In 2019, singer Princess Nokia alleged that Ariana Grande plagiarized one of her song lyrics entitled Mine, is found in the rap. However, this case didn't last long because Princess Nokia actually admitted that she was having fun because her song could inspire very famous singers like Ariana Grande. So this problem is not taken too seriously by Princess Nokia. still wrote the lead song, but not good news anymore, because the lead song Severance is caught tracing the tone of the song again from the song My Favorite Things from the legendary film The Sounds of Music. For those who don't know, The Sound of Music is an old film that tells the story of a Catholic sister named Maria. We can find this song in the section where Maria and the five children she fostered in the room and sing together. Unfortunately, the tone of this song is found in the lead song Ariana Grande entitled Seven Rings. Very similar to the lyrics of the song My Favorite Things, through the Seven Rings former Pete Davidson fans also mention the things he liked. Diamond are not exceptions. These lyrics are, yeah, breakfast that give me some bubbles and bubbles, girl with tattoos who like getting in trouble, lashes and diamonds, safety and machines, buy myself all of my favorite things, with raindrops and roses and whiskers on kittens, red copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, one pepper cake is tied up with dreams. These are a few of my favorite things. So, the last part on this paper is conclusion. The study presented the forensic stylistic analysis to detect plagiarism that used in English and Indonesian songs. They were found in English and Indonesian songs that indicate the existence of plagiarism, mostly from similarities or plagiarized tones of the songs mentioned in the previous explanation. So far, has not been found in plagiarism song lyrics or any meanings.